Hello everyone, welcome to Malkeith Academy. So in the previous video, we have successfully limited certain users from creating their own teams. So as for the example that we have limited this Jimmy user, that he or she cannot be able to create their teams on their own and can add members. So in this video, I will be showing how to limit students from creating their own private meetings and so many things. So we have to create all the policies from different things, from the messaging policy to the calling policy. So in the previous video, what the policy we have did is in the team policies that only the security, those people who are in the security group are only able to create the teams. But the work we have done in this previous video, that all the commands that we have written in the PowerShell, and the problem with the PowerShell is that this software and writing command scripts in the PowerShell is a little bit tricky for a lot of people cannot understand how to manage PowerShell and run scripts in this software. In this video, I will be telling you how you can create your custom policies, and it is very easy from the Teams admin panel. So in this video, I will be showing you how you can create your own custom policies so that these chats and calling and even private meetings could be limped down, so that students only attend the online meetings that are scheduled by the faculty members and nothing else. Because in a organization like a college or a school, this is a very big problem that students are talking to each other by having their private conversations, and they are scheduling their own meetings by going to calendars, and they are calling each and everyone. So this is a very big problem for a education institutions. So we have to limit that. For doing that, we have to create certain policies, and so whenever we are adding users into our organization, such as college or school, so the policies that are already assigned to them are global policies. So whenever we add a student or add a user in our Microsoft 365 admin center, the policy that is assigned to even students or faculty, that is global org. Global org means that all the private meetings, private chats, or even private teams can be created by all the users. For limiting certain users, we have to create our policies. So in the previous video, we have created a custom team policy that only the members who are in the security group are able to create their own teams. So to create custom policies without the use of PowerShell, we have to open up the Microsoft Teams admin panel. So for doing that, we have to click on here in the Teams admin centers. As you can see, there are some other admin centers like security, compliance, Azure, Active Directory, Exchange, SharePoint, and Teams. So when we click on this team admin center, it will take us to the Teams admin panel where we can create our custom policies. So as you can see on the screen, this is the Microsoft Teams admin center. So here, let me show you all the things that are here on this navigation pane on the left side. So there are teams, devices, location, users, meetings, messaging policies, team apps, voice, and assignments, org-wide settings, and so many things are here. So starting from the first point, that you have to click on the users, because here let me show you this thing, that whenever we added a student or a faculty member in the Microsoft 365 admin center, there are already policies assigned to these users. So if we I have clicked here on the users, as you can see, these are all the users in my organization. So these are all the users that has been added by this administrator in this Microsoft 365 admin center. So these users, whenever we add them, certain policies are assigned to them. For example, this particular user, has some policies assigned with when we created his or her account. So as you can see, when I scroll a little bit down here, global policy org by default. So by default, these policies are assigned to this user. Global org by means that no restrictions. Globally, they can use private chat, private meetings, even private calling, and even create teams. So meeting policy, messaging policies, all are global org by default. So in this video, I will be explaining how you can create your own custom meetings. So for doing that, let me start from this meetings. So click on the meetings and click on the meeting policies. So when you click on this meeting policies, it will list down all the meeting policies are already there. So I have created this EDU no private meeting before that, and I will be creating a custom policy here just for an example. So these are the policies. You can click on that and have a look at what a global policy look like. As you can see that all things are turned on, some things are turned off. And one thing more, that if you want to know about these settings further, just click here, click on learn more. So it will open up all the details about regarding these buttons and what they do or what they do not. Because for my point of view, that these settings are self-explanatory, that allow Meet Now channels, you have turn it on or off as you per your requirement. So there are audio and video, content sharing, you want to share your content, and participants and guests. So what kind of participants you want in your organization, like a guest, do you want to join the guest in your meetings or not. So let me start by making a custom policy. So for creating a custom policy, so that we can create this custom policy to our students. So I'm deleting this EDU no private meeting. So because I'm creating the same meeting policy, I'm not able to delete it because it is already assigned to one or more users. So you must assign different policies to those before you can delete this policy. So this is some kind of warning message. So I'm creating a new policy. For creating a new messaging or meeting policy, click on this add button. So at the top of this, you have to write the name of your meeting policy. So I am writing EDU no private meeting 2, because I have already named the one meeting policy. So this is the name of my meeting policy. And next thing is these are the general settings. So if you want to turn on or off, you can use as per your requirement. So I am making this meeting policy for students. I am turning off this Meet Now in my channel, so they cannot meet directly from the meeting. So I am also turning it off. Outlook add-in, and also channel meeting scheduling. So I am also turning it off. And in the later videos, I will be explaining how to use this Microsoft Teams in detail. And this thing we very much required in our students, that they cannot schedule private meetings. So I'm turning it off. Audio and video. So we do not want our students to record audio or video. I'm turning it off. And IP video, we can turn it off either. And again, if you want to learn more about these settings, you always click on learn more. It will take you to the official Microsoft website, and they will tell you more about these settings. But again, these all settings are self-explanatory. There is no need of going further in the official website of Microsoft. So screen sharing, you want screen sharing, you can turn it off or disable. So we can turn it on, because sometimes we need students to show something to a faculty member. Allow a participant to give a request control, that is obviously off. So we do not want that participant giving control of the meetings to other. Allow PowerPoint sharing, maybe on whiteboard on. So it depends on. So next thing is participants and guests. So let anonymous people start a meeting, definitely no. Automatically admit people. So if you want, turn it everyone in your organization. So when I do this, let me click here in the eye symbol here. So you can turn on or off if people that are anonymous are automatically joined the meeting. So we are doing it everyone in our organization. Allow dial-in user to bypass the lobby. So we do not want that they bypass our online meetings lobby. Allow meet now in private meeting. So definitely turning it off. So live caption, so we do not want to do live captions. Allow chat in meeting. So maybe we want chatting in the meetings so that something happening with our students, we can see that. So you should make it enable. After doing all these settings, just click on this saved. So I have successfully created a meeting policy. So this is only for the meeting policy. The policy EDU no private meeting too was successfully created. So after creating this policy, the next step is to assign it to your users. So for assigning it, we have to come here to the users. So click here any user. So I'm clicking this Alex Edward user. So click here and click on this edit setting button. When you click on this adding setting button, it will open up all the policies that is currently assigned to it. In this video, I am covering only one policies, and in the upcoming videos, I will be covering all the policies in detail. So as you on the screen, you can see we have all successfully created the meeting policies. So as these are the policies that are currently assigned to this particular user. So I am changing this meeting policy. So just click on the meeting policy button. Here on the drop down, you can see global or by default, all off, all on, EDU no private meeting to EDU no private meeting, and kiosk, restricted anonymous access, restricted anonymous no recording. So we have created this EDU no private meeting too. So click on that. And in the later video, we will be covering all these messaging policies and live events policy and calling policies. So we have to select from there. So till now, we are only changing this meeting policy, and click on apply. So this setting will be applied to this particular user. And one thing I want to add here, that if you want to add a policy to multiple users, because in your organization there are multiple users, just select these users one by one. And remember one thing, you can only select 20 participants, 20 users at a time. If you are try to select more than 20 students, you will get a warning message that you can only select 20 students, not more than 20. So if you are applying this any custom policies to your classes, so you have to select in 20 groups, because this Microsoft Teams admin will not allow you to do this. So this is a very hard kind of thing, that you have to select 20 students at a time. So more than 20 is not applicable here. So I have selected all these multiple users. Now I'm clicking on edit settings. And again, I'm changing only the meeting policy. So here, select this EDU no private meeting to and apply. So this all the users that I have selected here, the meeting policy has been changed. So as for the verification, I have signed in this Jimmy student account. And for this verification that this custom policy for meeting has been successfully assigned to this user or not. So I'm verifying here. So I'm clicking on the calendar and clicking on new meeting. So whenever this Jimmy student who has assigned this custom policy of EDU no private meetings, so whenever he or she try to schedule a meeting, for example, he is writing this meeting name, fun meeting, and whenever he's try to add some participants here, as you can see on the screen, you don't have permission to create private meetings. And if we try to add this in this meeting in the channel, again, you don't have permission to create the channel meetings. So this student cannot create private meetings. And one thing more here, as on the screen, you cannot see the meet now button because we have disabled this button. So we have successfully managed the no private meetings in our organization. And we have other things to cover, like private chats, but the student can do private chats, but we have to again make a custom policy for messaging. And this student can also make calls to other people in the organization. We have to also make this custom policy. So in the next video, I will be making these custom policies for chatting and calling in private meeting. And we can also disable certain apps from this user's account. And so these are all settings by going to Teams admin panel. So you can do all these settings by going to Teams admin panel. And I will be also providing all the links in the description box. You can also there, you can go also visit from there, use this application from there, or you can just click on this all admin center here, and you can also access this Teams admin center. Thanks for watching this video. So please do share and subscribe my channel. So see you in the next video.